I am the resurrection and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His compassion never fails. Every morning they are renewed. Jesus said, "Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. I am sure that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. If we live, we live to the Lord, and if we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end Christ died and lived again, that he may be the Lord both of the dead and of the living. We brought nothing into the world, and we take nothing out. The Lord gives, and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms.
With faith in Jesus Christ, we receive the body of our brother, Clarence Edward, for burial. Our brother was washed in holy baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Let us therefore with confidence pray to God, our Heavenly Father, the giver of life, that he will raise him to perfection in the company of the saints. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you this day our brother Clarence Edward. We thank you for giving him to us, his family and friends, to know and love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn, and give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course on earth until by your call we are reunited with those who have gone before through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Please sit for words of remembrance.
Good afternoon, church. I am Joel Eileen Dick. I am Clarence's sister. Clarence was born August the 1st, 1946. Clarence Edward Wilcher was the first son of Elaine Hayward and William Waterman, known to the family friends neighbors as Doki. He was blessed with a large family, 5 siblings, 4 sisters, 1 brother by my mother, and 4 brothers by his father. He was raised on College Line, where he spent most of his life. But who was Clarence Edward? As with most first sons, Clarence was close to our mother and lived across the street from her until her passing. His family was his pride and joy. There is nothing he would not do for any of us if he could not, or give to us if he had it to give. He was especially protective of his younger sister, Judy, and I, until his death. reminding us of how we should dress and conduct ourselves. For me, it was the ankle bracelet on my foot, which was a big no-no for him. Doki loved children, but had none of his own. So he treated all the children in the neighborhood as though they were his. Walk straight, go home. Your mother know where you are, get going, and especially for the girls. He no company for you. If I see you with him again, I'm going to tell Mr. or Mrs. or so-and-so. That was your parent. Sharon was a character trait for Doki. He loved cooking, but most important, loved sharing the food with anyone who just happened to pass by and call out to him. Some say he was reserved, others say quiet, while others say he was simply one of the good guys. A man who never had a harsh word for anyone, a friend to everyone. To us, his family and friends, he was simply Doki, a gentle and kind soul, genuine, caring, and giving, a simple man with a big heart. He loved the land and worked at Society Plantation from a young age until 2004. After the passing of her mother, he went to live in the neighboring of St. Joseph, where he found a new sense of purpose and direction. He continued to work as an agriculturalist until 2022, when he decided to return from paid employment. When his sight failed, Doki was wandering cared off by his sister-in-law, who I thank very much for taking care of her. Glenda, I thank you. And this is coming from my sister and I. She did take care of him for 6 months, looking after him, which we couldn't do. And we all appreciate it very much. And we all indebted to you for the excellent care you took care of our brother, uncle, and friend. When I spent time with him in late March of this year, his only complaint, which was a statement, was the darkness. He left him as a result of his failing sight. God, in his infinite wisdom and love, took his son, Clarence Edward, out of his personal darkness into light. When we miss him terribly, we take comfort in knowing you are now at rest. Clarence is preceded in death by his parents, his oldest sister, Carmen, his younger brother, Everton, by my mom, and 3 brothers, Winfred, Irwin, and Malcolm Wortman, by his father. Left to mourn the passing of our dear brother are his siblings, Lenora, Judy, and I, and Adrian Wortman, and nieces, nephews, and cousins. Sincere condolences are extended to our family from Avis and Lolita Blackman Payne of the US, Sharon Royal Campbell, Linda F. Howard, Margaret C. Haynes Bailey, Marilyn Herod of Toronto, and Trevor A. Bailey, and my aunt Lorna Lynch of England. May he rest in peace and rise in glory till we meet again. Thank you.
Him through all the changing scenes of life.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in your Son, Jesus Christ, you have given us a true faith and a sure hope. Strengthen this faith and hope in us all our days, that we may live as those who believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Please be seated for the first Bible reading.
Good evening, everyone. The first Bible reading is taken from Ecclesiastes 3, verse 1 to 8. To everything there is a season, a time for every purpose under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck what is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to cast away and a time to gather stones, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to gain and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to throw away, a time to hear and a time to sow, a time to keep silent and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. Here ends the reading.
Psalm 23, the Cremon version.
Yeah.
Second Bible reading.
Good afternoon, everyone. The second Bible reading is taken from St. John's Gospel, chapter 5, verses 24 to 27. Reading, "Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that heareth my word and believeth on him that sent me has everlasting life, and shall not come into condemnation, but shall pass from death unto life. Verily, verily, I say unto you, the hour is coming, and now is when the dead shall hear the voice of the Son of God, and there that hear shall live. For as the Father has life in himself, so has he given to the Son to have life in himself, and have given him authority to execute judgment, also because he is the Son of Man." Here ends the reading.
Hymn, "'Tis so sweet to trust in Jesus."
Thank you.
Please be seated. First, allow me to express our deepest condolences to the family and friends of Clarence on behalf of the church family here at Holy Cross. You can be assured of our continued prayers and support at this, your time of bereavement. And as you bid farewell to your loved one this afternoon, I want you to consider the notion of God's championing us, his being in our corner, his protection of us, his deliverance, his saving power, and his friendship, or as Paul puts it, God's being for us. For as he wrote in his letter to the Romans in verse 31b of chapter 8, if God is for us, who is against us? If God is for us, who is against us? Friends, I believe that most of us have at least one friend who is loyal to us, a friend who tells us the truth about things, whether we want to hear it or not, a friend who would give us their last, a friend who would do anything for us except break the law. But this is how God is with us. Except that it is on a level that we cannot truly grasp or comprehend. For God's being for us is just one of the many facets of the love that he has for us, a love on which we can wholeheartedly rely. As a matter of fact, we have been told in the same letter to the Romans that there's nothing and no one in all of creation that can separate us from the love of God in Christ. Indeed, Paul asked in Romans 8, verses 35 and 37 to 39, who will separate us from the love of God? Will hardship or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? And he then answered his own questions with a resounding no, going on to tell us that in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For he was convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Now, I don't know about you, but to my mind, these words which Paul wrote to the Christians at Rome are some of the most beautiful words found in the Bible. Certainly, they are words which can affirm and encourage and reassure us at any and every stage of our lives. Surely, they are words which can strengthen us in sickness, lift us high in our joys, comfort us in our sorrows, and give us peace at our end. As a matter of fact, I believe that these words are right up there with the text from the Gospel of John, which tells us that God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him may not perish, but may have everlasting life. So when the Apostle Paul asked the question, if God is for us, who is against us? He could only conclude, to quote William Barclay, that God is so loyal to his human creation that he sacrificed his only son for us. And surely we must be able to trust their loyalty like that, especially since there are so many stories in the Bible which illustrate God's loyalty to those who love him. Stories of people like the patriarch Abraham and his grandson Jacob and their descendant David, the shepherd boy who became a king. For God promised Abraham a son from his wife and gave him Isaac in their advanced years. God promised Jacob that he would be with him wherever he went and he would bring him back to the land of his father. And he did exactly that. And despite all the persecution by King Saul, God protected David until he became the king of Israel. Such were the experiences of these persons in the Bible. But we too in our modern era can look at our own experiences as well. For there's a saying we have that God don't come, but he does send. Pardon the dialect. We also say that God is good all the time, or as is attributed to St. Augustine, without God, we cannot, and without us, God will not. These are sayings that must have come into use because of people's experiences with God. People who found out for themselves that God always raises up people in our lives who are willing to fight for us, who are willing to help us. People who discover that God always has a champion. But have we discovered this truth for ourselves? Are we God's champion for anyone? Who or what are we willing to stand up for? Who are we willing to go up against? Who are we willing to help? Who are we willing to protect or to speak up for? As you would have heard in the eulogy, Clarence seemed to have been that kind of person for his sisters and his siblings and the little children in the villages. How many times have you cried out to God for help during difficult circumstances and he answered you, not by coming, but by sending someone with advice or a hug or a lift or money or foodstuff or just a listening ear? God never fails us because he is for us. He's our deliverer, he's our friend, he's our provider, our protector, our savior, and he's our guide. Friends, it is a fact of life that there will be times when we will struggle. There will also be times when we may even believe that God does not know that we are here or that he does not really care about us, since to our limited minds, if he knew or cared, then he would not have let this thing or the next thing happen to us. Or he would give us this thing, or he would give us that thing. This thinking is understandably human, but we should not allow these kinds of thoughts to take root and grow in our lives, since they are in direct opposition to the love which God displayed in sending his only Son to our world to die for us. And furthermore, life should have taught us by now that no human being, and that includes all of us, no one gets a pass on suffering. And as we can see from all the conflict in the world and all the damage caused by Hurricane Beryl as she raced through our island a few days ago and some other Caribbean islands, human pain and suffering and misery are not imaginary things, but are real things. But we must also not forget what Jesus said in John 16, verse 33, "In this world, we will have trouble, but we are to take heart, for he overcame the world." Friends, some of us have read the stories in the pages of the Bible over and over and over again. Some of us have read the history books. We watch the news on the TV and we hear and see the images of hunger and starvation and conflict and disease in the world. But Paul reassures us that even though we may be having challenges now, that this too shall pass. We will overcome them because God works all things to the good of those who love the Lord. So if we have never thought about it up to now, then it is high time that we take some time to look back and recognize how the circumstances in our lives would have shifted and changed over the years, always for progress, always for welfare, always for good, even after unfortunate things may have happened to us. Is God a liar? Isn't he our deliverer? Isn't he for us? Family and friends of Clarence, there's no denying that we will never be able to see the big picture, no matter how we strain our eyes, for our lives are too small, and so is the view that we have. But we can trust the one who has a complete view of our lives, for he is a God who protects us and delivers us and guides us. He is a God who is for us. Clarence's journey on this earth is now over, but we are still here. So as we continue to navigate the present world with the catastrophic effects of climate change, the tough economic realities, the volatile political environments, the wars and their terrible effects, it is my prayer for all of you, as Clarence's family members and as Clarence's friends, that you would hold on to the promises that are found in God's word. For if God is indeed for us, then we can fearlessly ask, who is against us? May Clarence's soul rest in peace. Amen. Let us now all stand and with confidence and hope confess the faith into which we were baptized as we say the Apostles' Creed, found on page 5 of your leaflet. I believe in God, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried, descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again, ascended into heaven. I believe in the Holy Spirit, Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, please remain standing for the prayers and commendation.
In the session C, your response at the end of each petition is, hear our prayer. We pray for those who mourn, and we commemorate the departed Clarence Edward. Let us pray with confidence to God, our Father, who raised our Lord Jesus from the dead for the salvation of all. Grant, Lord, that your servant may know the fullness of which you have promised to those who love you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Be close to those who mourn. Increase the faith in your undying love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
May we be strengthened in our faith, live the rest of our lives in fellowship with your Son, and be ready when you call us to the fullness of life. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Show your mercy to the dying, strengthen them with hope, and fill them with peace and joy of your presence. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We commend all people to your unfailing love, that in them your will may be fulfilled, and rejoice in the faithful witness of your saints in every age, praying that we may share with them in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
Father of all, we pray to you for Clarence Edward and for all those whom we love but see no longer. Grant to them eternal rest. Let light perpetual shine upon them. May he and all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. Give rest, O Christ, to your servant with your saints, where sorrow and pain are no more. Neither sighing, but life everlasting. You only are immortal, the creator and maker of humankind, and we are mortal, formed of the earth, and to earth shall we return. For so did you ordain when you created us, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust. Yet even at the grave we make our song, Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Give rest, O Christ, to your servant with your saints, where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing, but life everlasting. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Our Father, thanks, kingdom, power, and Clarence, O Sovereign Lord Christ, from all evil, and set him free from every bond, that he may rest with all your saints in the eternal habitations, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant Clarence. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, in the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen.
During the singing of the hymn, Come Thee That Love the Lord, a collection will be taken.
Let us pray. The God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well pleasing in his sight, through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. The Nunc Dimittis.
Thank you.
Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down death by death, and giving life to those in the tomb. The Son of Righteousness is gloriously risen, giving light to those who sat in darkness and in the shadow of death. The Lord will guide our feet into the way of peace, having taken away the sin of the world. Christ will open the kingdom of heaven to all who believe in his name, saying, "Come, O blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you." Into paradise may the angels lead you. At your coming, may the martyrs receive you and bring you into the holy city, Jerusalem.
Happy August.
Faith of Christ, henceforth, says the Spirit, they may rest from their labors, for they take with them the record of their deeds. Man born of a woman has but a short time to live. Like a flower, he blossoms and then withers. Like a shadow, he flees and never stays. In the midst of life, we are in death. To whom can we turn for help but to you, Lord, who are justly angered by our sins? Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us from the bitter pains of eternal death. You know the secrets of our hearts. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Forgive us our sins, and at our last hour, let us not fall away from you. In sure and certain hope of resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our brother Clarence Edward, and we commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. And we beseech you in your infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor, that when your well-beloved Son shall come again in judgment, both this, our brother Clarence Edward, and we ourselves may be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, with whom still live the spirits of those who die in the Lord, and with whom the souls of the faithful are in joy and felicity, we give you heartfelt thanks for the good examples of all your servants who, having finished their course in faith, now find rest and refreshment. May we, with all who have died in the true faith of your holy name, have perfect fulfillment and bliss in your eternal and everlasting glory, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the resurrection and the life, raise us, we humbly pray, from the death of sin to the life of righteousness, that when we depart this life, we may rest in him, and at the resurrection receive that blessing which your well-beloved Son shall then pronounce. Come, you blessed of my Father, receive the kingdom prepared for you from the beginning of the world. Grant this, O merciful Father, through Jesus Christ, our mediator and redeemer. Amen. Grant, O Lord, to all who are bereaved, the spirit of faith and courage, that they may have strength to meet the days to come with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of your great goodness and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. And this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Rest eternal grant to him, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon him. May he and all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. the hymn "I'll Fly Away."
Someday morning when this life is o'er, I'll fly away, fly away, to a home on our celestial shore. I'll fly away, fly away, fly away, I'll fly away, fly away, oh glory. I'll fly away, fly away in the morning when I die, hallelujah, by and by.
The hymn "When the Roll Is Called" up yonder. Blessed Assurance. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore we will not fear, though the earth be moved, and though the mountains be toppled into the depths of the sea, though its waters rage and foam, and though the mountains tremble at its tumult. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. There's a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be overthrown. God shall help her at the break of day. The nations make much ado, and the kingdoms are shaken. God has spoken, and the earth shall melt away. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. Come now and look upon the works of the Lord. What awesome things he has done on earth. It is he who makes war to cease in all the world. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear and burns the shields with fire. Be still, then, and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. The hymn, there's a new name written down in glory.
I was once a sinner, but I came, pardon to receive from my Lord. This was freely given, and I found that he always cared.
Written down in glory. And
Lord, you have been our refuge from one generation to another. Before the mountains were brought forth, or the land and the earth were born, from age to age you are God. You turn us back to the dust and say, go back, O child of earth. For 1,000 years in your sight are like yesterday when it is past, and like a watch in the night. You sweep us away like a dream. We fade away suddenly like the grass. In the morning it is green and flourishes. In the evening it is dried up and withered. For we consume away in your displeasure. We are afraid because of your wrathful indignation. Our iniquities you have set before you, and our secret sins in the light of your countenance. When you are angry, all our days are gone. We bring our years to an end like his sight. The span of our life is 70 years, perhaps in strength even 80. Yet the sum of them is but labor and sorrow, for they pass away quickly and we are gone. Who regards the power of your wrath? Who rightly fears your indignation? So teach us to number our days that we may apply our hearts to wisdom. Return, O Lord, how long will you tarry? Be gracious to your servants. Satisfy us by your loving kindness in the morning. So shall we rejoice and be glad all the days of our life. Make us glad by the measure of the days that you afflicted us, and the years in which we suffered adversity. Show your servants your works and your splendor to their children. May the graciousness of the Lord our God be upon us. Prosper the work of our hands. Prosper our handiwork. The hymn, To God Be the Glory.
Thank you. Worship your holy name, Jesus. worship your holy name.
We remember with thanksgiving Clarence Edward, whom we love but see no longer, and we pray that in him your perfect will may be fulfilled through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord bless him and keep him. The Lord make his face to shine upon him and be gracious to him. The Lord lift up his countenance upon him and give him peace, both now and forevermore. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us depart in peace. Amen.
The Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you. Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace.
We agree. Amen.